next segment of interviews will feature Chris Bowater, my co-presenter, Noel Richards and Sue Rinaldi. And they have a lot to say and a lot to share in their experience in praise and worship. Check out their heart.
3 years traveling around the UK, sharing the vision at our concert, saying, would you come to the stadium? And all these people came. And to see that place where so many gods of sport and music have been worshipped, resounding to the praises of Jesus, it was just an incredible sight. And whenever I see the footage on the video which we shot of the day, I mean, it just moves me to tears, because it's not the people on the stage, it's the people in the crowd. Mm-hmm. And to see them at worship and at prayer, and to see them being touched by God's love, it was just wonderful. Simply, I guess praise is, you know, God, you're great, you're wonderful, we think you're terrific. Whereas worship is a much more intimate expression, saying, God, not only do we think you're terrific, but you know, you are the object of our affection. You know, we want to know you more than our closest friend. Ministering in season and out of season. In other words, getting on with it whether you feel like it or not. Mm-hmm. And we all have days where we feel we've just had a bad day, got stuck in the traffic, we've had too many bills, all those sorts of things. But nonetheless, God hasn't changed. And my circumstances have changed, but God hasn't. And there was an occasion a few years ago when we were doing the Warrior Tour, when we had 3 nights on a row, and at the end of the first night I spoke to my wife, and one of the key young guys in our church had died that day, unexpectedly, just died in his sleep, 14 years old, same age as my son at the time. And we were just gutted as a church. It was the first time anybody in our church had died in over 20 odd years of existence as a church. And I then had to go on the next night because he was kept on a life support machine in the hope that maybe he would not be brain dead, but he was. And the afternoon of the second day when I was on the road, they switched off the machine. I had to get on stage that night and do a concert and sing about the victory of Jesus, even though we'd lost one of our warriors. That was very difficult. But I realized as I sang, who can mend hearts that are broken? And as I sang, he is risen, I realized the words that we're singing, they're still true. God hasn't changed. Death is part of life. Unexpected death, sadly, is a part of life also, but God hasn't changed, and the words are true, that one day we'll all be reunited anyway, and this is only for a season. And so, you know, you cling to that fact, that your circumstances may have changed, but God hasn't, and you just get on with it. I think what we're seeing with a lot of the institutional churches, the numbers going down. The only churches that really are growing, and the only denominations that are growing, are the ones that are open to what God is currently doing at this point in time in history. And so we're seeing what is known as the charismatic evangelical wing of the church is the fastest growing wing of the church, along with the Pentecostals. We're seeing a decline, for example, in the other denominations, where they're not sure what they believe. Because as Chesterton said, when you stop believing in God, you don't believe in nothing, you believe in anything. And sadly, a lot of these churches within the established denominations aren't sure exactly what they should be believing. That's a very general statement, because there are some very fine churches within all the established denominations. But I think God is looking for a people who will respond to what he is doing in this world at this time. And music does have a part to play, but more importantly, it's the people who are saying, we're going to go with what God wants. And when you've got a group of people who are saying, we'll go with what God wants, fresh melodies, fresh songs, fresh music comes out of that.
We will raise a shout, we will shout it out, he is the champion.